Good morning, all. Today I am going to discuss the one of the applications of combinational circuits. So here I am going to discuss the topic of amp. So it is a combinational circuit. In digital electronics, we have two kinds of circuits. One is combinational circuit, and the another one is sequential circuit. The difference between combinational circuit and sequential circuit is, in the combinational circuits, we have combinational and sequential. In the combinational circuit, the output of this combinational circuit depends on present inputs. For example, it is a combinational circuit, it has an output. Its output depends on inputs, whereas sequential circuit, this output not only depends on inputs but also depends on previous output. So here the sequential circuit output depends on both present inputs and previous output. So here I am going to discuss half adder. This half adder is a combinational circuit. So that means its output depends on present inputs. So how can we design any circuit? We have a certain procedure. That is, we have two kinds of procedures. One is analysis procedure and another one is design procedure. So for designing this half adder, I am using design procedure. So what is the design procedure means? We have a few kinds of flowcharts. Like flowchart, we have few steps. So one is, first we need to have a truth table of what are the circuit that we are going to design. The first step is we need to implement truth table of particular circuit. And the second one is, so from the truth table we need to go for K-max. From the truth table we need to go for K-max. So why we are going for K-map means, here the K-map is used for equation minimization. So from the truth table, next step is we go for K-maps. In this K-map, we get equations. That equations are minimized equations. So once we got the equations, we implement the logic diagram from the equations. So these are the few steps we need to follow while designing any combinational circuit. Now I design half adder by following these three steps. So I have taken the combinational circuit half adder. Now I am saying that I'm going to construct this half adder. So I have already explained what are the steps that I want to follow while designing this half adder. The first step is, we need to implement truth table for half adder. The first step is we need to implement truth table for half adder. So we have first, what is half adder? It is a one kind of adder circuit. So it will add two binary digits and it will produce two kinds of output. So what are the possible outputs? Are sum and carry. So half adder can add two binary digits and it can produce two possible outputs. The possible outputs are sum and carry. So I am assuming two inputs are A and B, and the outputs are sum and carry. So my inputs are A, B, outputs are sum and carry. If my two inputs are 0, 0, so as we have two inputs, the maximum possible inputs are 4. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. These are the maximum possibilities for a two inputs. So if my inputs are 0, 0, what are the outputs? If inputs are 0, 0, sum is 0, again carry is 0. And here inputs are 0, 1. The sum is 1, carry is 0. So here inputs are 1, 0. 1, 0 is nothing but adding 1 and 0. If you add 1 and 0, my sum is 1. Here I am not getting any extra carry, so that's why carry is 0. Here sum is 1, carry is 0. Here I am adding 1, 1. 1, 1 means 1, 1 means 1 plus 1, it is 2, but in binary it is 1, 0. So we write 1, 0 like this. So here the sum is 0, carry is 1. So here sum is 0 and carry is 1. This is the truth table for my half adder. Now my second step. My second step is we need to obtain the equations from this truth table. So we can directly go from the table, or we can use KMap to get the equations. So I am going to generate two equations here because I have two outputs, sum and carry. For that sum and carry, I need to obtain the two equations. So I am going to implement the equations for sum and carry. First, I am going to apply the equation for sum. So AB are my inputs. So place the sum values into the KMap. So here it is 0, 1, 1, 0. So I can't group. Grouping is not possible. So these are individual. That is A bar A, B bar B. So equation will be this one and this one. That is A bar B plus A, B bar. This is the equation for sum. We know that A bar B plus A B bar is equal to exclusive OR operation. So simply I can write A XOR B. It is the expression for sum. In the same way, we apply the equation for carry. So write the KMap. It is for carry. B bar B, A bar A. So place the carry values into the KMap. That is 0, 0, 0, 1. So here we have only possibility is this. So my equation for carry is equal to AB, and C is equal to AB. So these are the two equations I have. These are the two equations I have. So first step is we have obtained the truth table for my corresponding combinatorial circuit, that is half adder. I have obtained the truth table. And the second step is I have obtained the equations by using KMaps. So the third step is design. So based on these two equations, we need to design the final circuit using the logic gate. So here we have two equations. S is equal to AX plus AX plus or B, and carry is equal to AB. So take the A and B. So A exclusive or B. It is the exclusive OR gate. It is exclusive OR gate. It is the expression for sum. And again, this equation is over. And we need to draw the circuit for this equation. A and B. Take this A and take this B. So we know that A into B, we use multiplication AND gate. For multiplication we use AND gate. So this is the expression for carry. So it is a simple half adder circuit. It is a simple half adder circuit. So what we have done is we have designed the combinatorial circuit, that is half adder. So for that we have followed this procedure. So one is truth table, and the second step is writing the KMaps. From the KMaps, we need to obtain the equations. After obtaining the equation, we go for designing part using logic gates. So this is about half adder. In the same way, we will go to design full adder. So I am going to explain the full adder. So the difference between half adder and full adder is the full adder can add 3 binary digits, whereas half adder can only add 2 binary digits, whereas full adder can add three binary digits. So for the same procedure we need to follow to design this full array. First step is we need to write the truth table. Second step is we need to write the equations. And third step is from the equations we need to draw the logic diagram. So without any delay, I am going to draw the truth table for this full array. So I am assuming that So A, B, C are my three inputs. So the difference between op array and full array is full array can only add two digits, whereas full array can add own three digits, whereas op array can add two. So that's why I am taking the three inputs. So from the three inputs, what are the maximum possibilities? So eight possibilities I get. That is 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. These are the eight possibilities for a three inputs. Again I have a sum, again I have a carry. So in order to differentiate this C and this carry, I am just assuming this is carry in and this is carry out. Sorry, C out. Actually why we go for full adder is basically, so in the designing part, this full combination of series of these full adders will be used for designing any circuit. So we have row of adders. So this output is again forwarded to another full adder. So I am assuming that this is carry out and again this is carry in. So no need to confuse. I am just assuming that it is C in and it is C out. So again we need to draw the we need to mention the values for these possibilities. 0 plus 0 plus 0. Sum is 0, carry 0. Here sum is 1, carry 0. Here sum is 1, carry 0. 0 plus 1 plus 1. It is 2. 2 means in binary 2 means 1 0. So 1 is my carry, 0 is sum. So sum 0, carry 1. Again, sum 1, carry 0. 0, 1. 0, 1. Here I have a 1 plus 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1 means 3. In binary 3 means 1, 1. So it is carry and it is sum. So sum means 1 and carry is also 1. This is the truth table for my full adder. And the construction of the obtaining the truth table part is over. The second step is we need to get the equations. So we need to obtain the equations for this corresponding truth table. So first I am going to build the KMF for sum. After that I will build the KMF for carry out. So I am going to take a three variable KMF here. So in the previous session we have taken the two variable KMF because in the op adder we have only two inputs. So that's why I have taken the two variable KMF. But here I have a three inputs. So as I have a three inputs, I need to go for three variable KMF. So my inputs are A, B, C. So A bar, A. B bar, C in bar. B bar, C in. B, C in. B, C in bar. So up to, place these values into the KMF. So 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So these are the, this is the KMF for corresponding truth table. That too for sum. So I don't get any objects or points or pairs. So those all are individual. So I can simply write like sum is equal to A bar B bar C in plus A bar B C in bar plus A B bar C in bar plus A B C in bar. So after simplifying we can get that A exclusive or B exclusive or C in. This is the final expression for sum. So if you take the common from this, I'll get the expression for exclusive or operation. And we need to obtain the equation for carry out. The same way, take the three variable KMF, place the values on the KMF, that is 00, 01, and 0111. So in this we can have a three pairs. These are the three pairs in the carry out chain. So for this I can write the expression carry is equal to, this is one group, that is A bar A, B bar C in bar, B bar C in, B C in, B C in bar. So write the expression for this three pairs. So B C in, B C in is the one term, plus A, A C in is the other term, and A, A B is the another term. As we have a three pairs, in the output expression we have three terms. So these are the equations. One is A squeeze over B squeeze over C in, another one is B C in plus A C in plus A B. B C in plus A C in plus A B. So we have the equations. A and the, sorry, sum and the carry, we have the two equations. So as we have the equations, we can easily construct the circuit diagram by using logic gates. So that's it.